Looks like there's only one way out of here.
Edgar? Jess, behind you!
Thank you. Thanks for the hand. But I had it under control.
Can tell.
The locals call it La Orquídea de la Vida or something foreign like that. We get this back to Calico, squeeze it out, and maybe we have ourselves a way to turn this around.
I'm sorry I got you into this.
Yeah. Getting your ass out of the fire has kind of become a habit.
Edgar, you can't keep doing this forever.
When those ticks attacked the manor, what did your father do? Run? Nah. He kept on squeezing the trigger. That's what he did. People like us don't retire, Jesse. Even if you're lucky enough to live long enough, you'll soon realize there's nothing waiting for you. There is no normal for people like me or your father. And I was naive to think there might be some normal for you. Anyway, now that just about everyone else in the Institute is dead, I figure you and your daddy are gonna need all the help you can get to build things back up again.
Well, first you give me those pretty flowers, then you get all emotional on me.
Yo.
Edgar, you ain't gonna try to kiss me now, are you?
You little shit.
What up, Chris? Hold on, I'm finishing up this, this little mission from this game. Hold up. What you doing? Did you watch the Michigan game?
God damn it.
Are you watching the Washington game?
You backstabbing witch. You ratted us out.
Dr. Blackwell.
Yeah.
I know we've had our differences.
The Michigan game?
For your information,
It was kind of slow at the beginning, huh?
But thank you for confirming how little faith you have in me. Now, I don't presume to know how things work for you, gentlemen. But I can assure you that Calico wasn't built on broken words and betrayed.